Hi, I'm Chris Jansen from TriathleteMind.com and welcome to Hyde Park, London, the heart of the West End and the home of the 2012 Olympics men's and women's triathlon event. As you can see behind me, the preparations are well underway. We're going to take a look at what the athletes are going to experience on their big day.
So here we are looking down on the first turn of the race. It's 200 meters from the start all the way up to this first corner where athletes are going to be fighting for position all the way up. It's an all-out sprint to get to this first buoy. Once they round this corner, head back for the long back stretch where you start to see the group separate and athletes fighting for all they can to bridge up to the next group. Let's take a look from the other end of the course at the last turn. So here we are now at the east end of the Serpentine. We were on the bridge down there before, or the first turn. Now we're at the last turn. At this point of the race, the athletes will have almost 1,000 meters of a straight swim all the way down the course. Now they're going to make their final turn and head back to the starting pontoons, where they'll exit the water. You really want to make sure you're in that first wave to give yourself the best chance heading into T1 and onto the bike. Let's now take a look at what athletes can expect on the bike course around Hyde Park and down to Buckingham Palace. So as they exit Hyde Park through Queen Mother Gate, they enter the streets of London. This is where the technical part of the course begins. Lots of tight corners around the roundabouts, tight corners into Wellington Arch. Let's take a look at what happens there.
So as they come out of Hyde Park corner and head down here, this is a really sharp corner where athletes have to come very, very slowly through here as they head to Wellington Arch. So here we are, under the gates, the majestic gates of Wellington Arch, one of the most iconic and interesting parts on the course. Fascinating for the spectators, challenging for the athletes. Why is that? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 paces wide. That's not a lot of space for anybody. Comfortably 3 athletes, at the most 4 cyclists at a time. So you're gonna have 30 plus cyclists coming flying through here, 25, 30 miles an hour, heading down Constitution Hill to Buckingham Palace.
Down Constitution Hill from the arch, there's a bit of a decline coming down the hill, so the competitors will have lots of speed as they come whipping out in front of Buckingham Palace and Queen Victoria statue. From there, they go into some really tight corners, a very technical part of the course, before they come back out in front of the palace, up Constitution Hill again, through Wellington Arch and into the park. This is the section of the course we can expect to see some breakaways, or at least some breakaway attempts. Will the competitor be able to get out in front and really make a mark, or will the pack catch up? So coming back into Hyde Park, they've got about a 1 kilometer stretch of nice smooth asphalt heading all the way into T2. As they transition into T2 on the run, the first part of the run course will duplicate part of the bike course. Will go over the bridge at the west end of the Serpentine and come all along the shore of the Serpentine. They'll run that lap 4 times and then they'll head back to the final stretch and hopefully some glory. Here we are at the only turning point on the run course across an Africa village. This is the only point on the course where the athletes are going to have a chance to see each other going out to the turn point and back in, which means the leaders are going to have a chance to see how much of a gap they have as they head back towards the Serpentine and along the Serpentine for the loop of the run. Here's also where the competitor is going to realize how much more work they have to do to make a move for the medal position. So here we are, the final stretch, the final 200 meters. There'll be thousands of people lining the road here, waving their flags, cheering on their favorites. The only question that remains is, will the favorites be able to pull off victory as expected, or is there an exciting upset in the making? I hope you've enjoyed this preview of the London 2012 Olympic triathlon events in Hyde Park. For TriathleteMind.com, I'm Chris Jansen.